clearance of the substance, the formula of creatinine clearance, urea clearance, any one, is milligram of substance excreted per minute divided by milligram of substance per ml of the plasma. Means that's excretion in the urine and that's value in the plasma. The formula comes to be C means clearance, that is ml per minute is equal to U into V by P, where U is the concentration of that substance, for example, maybe creatinine, in the urine, in the test, into volume of the urine passed per minute, divided by P. P means the level of that substance, for example, creatinine or urea, anything in the plasma. The substance freely filtered across capillary wall and neither secreted nor reabsorbed, as I have told you earlier, is the ideal for GFR collection. And in that ideal GFR test material, creatinine is chosen, as it is a substance which is produced inside the body. It is inulin is also a substance which gives the value equal to GFR, but inulin is a substance which I have to give to the patient from outside. That is the negative point. In the case of creatinine, it is a substance produced in the body. It is formed from creatinine phosphate in the muscle. Its level depends on muscle mass of the body, but not affected by diet, age, or exercise. But it is affected by sex. Women and children excrete less than men due to less muscular mass. Since production of creatinine is continuous, the blood level is also constant and excretion is also constant in urine. These two things makes the creatinine an ideal clearance test substance. As the excretion of creatinine is constant 24 hours, collecting of urine is not needed as a sample of 24 hours, but single collection is enough for the test, which is especially helpful in children and mentally retarded persons. The reference value of the creatinine in plasma is adult male 0.7 to 1.4 milligram per dl, adult female 0.6 to 1.3 milligram per dl, children 0.5 to 1.2 milligram per dl, and the GFR comes to be 95 to 115 ml per minute in the adult male, adult female 85 to 110 milliliter per minute. There are also some disadvantages of using creatinine, and this disadvantage is creatinine is filtered by glomeruli and actively excreted by the tubules, and that portion which is actively secreted by the tubules is 10% of the total excretion. Creatinine clearance is said to be 10 to 20 ml per minute, much more than GFR, which you get as a result. When the GFR is reduced, the secretion component is increased and it neutralizes the results. Means, if the filtration is reduced in the glomeruli, the tubular secretion compensates it. So, in the initial stage of filtration defect, we do not get a good result. That is very, very very early stage of disease in GFR may not be identified by creatinine clearance, and this is known as creatinine blind area. You must know about the creatinine blind area. Maybe that I could not make you a clear statement, but just go and read about this. This is creatinine blind area. What is this? As I told you, this creatinine, when we do the creatinine clearance, the value which comes to be, it comes to be 95 to 115 or 120 milliliter per minute per 1.73 square meter surface area. When we use urea as a clearance test, as you know, it is reabsorbed in the tubules, the value comes to be less, that is nearly about 75 milliliter per minute. About the inulin, being a substance which can only be given from outside, for which we need a purely sterilization of the substance, there may be reaction, there may be something else, we do not use it, we use creatinine. The another thing which is nowadays sometimes used for the clearance test is cystatine C as a GFR marker. Cystatine C, the cause behind is it is a non-glycolated protein. It is formed in high concentration in biological fluid and virtually present in all organs of the body. Blood level is nearly 0.8 to 1.2 milligram per liter. It is produced at constant rate and freely filtered at glomeruli. It is completely reabsorbed by but degraded in the tubules, completely reabsorbed. But degraded in the tubules. These are the few things which also makes it a substance of choice for GFR calculation. In the next class, I will tell you something about the test done for tubular function, which are very simple. Another test which are done for glomerular permeability are, that is, quantitative detection of protein in urine. Which there are few conditions which are you must know. Those are glomerular proteinuria, microalbuminuria, and overflow proteinuria. इसके बारे में आप लोग देख लेंगे किताब से. अगला क्लास हम फिर I will take on tubular function of the kidney. अब कितना हम डिटेल में आ गया क्या
ठीक है.